नमस्कारम ओम
नमस्कार
सर्वेभ्यो नमः। अद्य अस्माकं वेद संस्कृति समित्याः अष्टषष्टितम वेबिनार प्रसंगं प्रचलति। अद्य मुख्यवक्ता श्री प्रमोद कुमार एसजी महोदयः, सः इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ गुरुकुल सिस्टम ऑफ एजुकेशन एट शांति धाम ए वैदिक वर्ल्ड प्रोजेक्ट इति इति नाम प्रसंगम अधिकृत्य किंचित् वक्तुकामः। सर्वे अपि गुरुकुल विद्या विधानम प्रामुख्यतम पुरस्कृत्य ज्ञातुं बहु उत्सुकवन्तः। प्रथमः प्रार्थनां कृत्वा वयं अस्माकं प्रोग्राम प्रारंभं कुर्मः। ओम श्री महागणाधिपतये नमः। ओम शुक्लांबरधरं विष्णुं शुचिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिगुं हवामहे कविं कवीनाम् उपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनशृण्वन्नूतिभिः सीदसादनम्। ओं श्री महागणाधिपतये नमः। ओं गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। ओं प्रणोदेवी सरस्वती वाजेभिर्वाजिनीवती धीनामवित्र्यवतु। ओम श्री महासरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम मातृदेवो भव पितृदेवो भव आचार्य देवो भव अतिथिदेवो भव। ओम सदाशिवसमारंभां व्यासशंकरमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय। ओम शांति शांति शांति। अद्य अस्माकं वेद संस्कृति समित्याः उपाध्यक्ष श्रीमती ललिताजी, ऐ रिक्वेस्ट श्रीमती ललिताजी टू कंडक्ट द प्रोग्राम एंड इंट्रोड्यूस अवर ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट टू द ऑगस्ट ऑडियंस। श्री ललिताजी श्रीमती।
थैंक यू अम्मा, धन्यवादः एंड सर्वेभ्यः नमस्कारः। आई वेलकम अवर मेन स्पीकर ऑफ द डे, अवर गेस्ट स्पीकर श्री प्रमोद कुमार एसजी, हु इज द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ ओम शांति धाम। इट्स अ लीडिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन व्हिच हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द गुरुकुला सिस्टम एज अ वैदिक ग्लोबल प्रोजेक्ट and he is a very very tedious job, like I can say that he has his very good background experience. First I would like to introduce about him. He is the secretary of Om Shanti Dhamma Veda Pathashala and he has been graduated as an engineer from University of Mysore. Mr. Pramod has been a thinker and researcher in education. He has been analyzing various alternative education systems and philosophies of education before realizing the uniqueness and holistic approach of Gurukula system of education. And Mr. Pramod has been associated with Om Shanti Dhamma from past 17 years. Apart, he has also presented papers on Vedic philosophy of education in various international conferences on education. And he's also been consultative and in the and executive team where they have established a Vedic residential school called Acharya Kulam of Patanjali Yoga Peeth at Haridwar. There are many such merits to his wide experience and I think it's a rare privilege for all of us to have him here. Om Shanti Dham. We first of all thank him on behalf of Ved Samskruti Samiti, our president Akella Prabhakar Mahodaya, who will join us very soon, and all our vice presidents and our committee members, and also our august audience, because all our looking with eagerness to know more about the Gurukula system of education, particularly what Shanti, Om Shanti Dhamma is doing in this present day, where, you know, finding Sanskrit or finding the scriptures, teaching of our ancient scriptures, Shanti Dhamma, our Sanatan Dharma, all this is almost, we are not able to find it anywhere. In that system, you are really doing wonderful job. I really request, I think it's all our, we are eagerly waiting for it, and we all need it, that you have agreed to come and tell us what exactly Om Shanti Dhamma is doing here for the betterment of our community, and especially in Hindustan, what we require as Hindus. We feel proud to be part of it, and I invite the chief speaker of the day, Mr. Pramod Kumar ji, to really take over the session and give his speech to all of us. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, thank you. Sarve Bhyo Namaha. I hope my screen is visible to all, right?
Yes, yes, it is visible. It is
yes.
Visible.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. So our main topic is introduction to Gurukula system of education and how it is being implemented at Om Shanti Dham. Let me first speak on essential features of Gurukula system of education. So what are those? So first one is the Vedic philosophy of education. What exactly is Vedic philosophy of Vedic education? The next thing is, the next main pillar is the qualities of an acharya or the teacher, where the guru or a guru, where the Gurukula system is being implemented. Then comes the shishya.
Lalitaji,
kindly mute all others except our speaker.
Yes, yes, I am doing that. I think I'll mute all and then I'll mute. Sir, I'll unmute you just for 1 second.
Okay.
I'll
okay.
Mute all and then I'll unmute you, please.
Okay, fine. Yes, ma'am. You are visible. I hope my voice is now visible.
Yes, 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 it's clear.
Okay, yes. Okay. So the first one is the philosophy of Vedic education. The next is the acharya and how the graduated the shishya or the student or a brahmachari, what is the outcome that is being expected from him? The next thing is, and the last one is the ideal environment for Gurukula from the reference of the Vedas. So these are the four pillars, so which I have identified as essential features of Gurukula system of education. And also we get the references from Vedic scriptures as well. So first one I'll take up as the Vedic philosophy of education. So what is Vedic philosophy of education or philosophy of Vedic education? So it says, the Upanishad says, vidyamcha avidyamcha yastad vedyo bhayam saha avidyaya mrityum tirtva vidyaya amrutam ashnute. What is it? He who knows paravidya and aparavidya together crosses death through aparavidya and attains immortality through vidya. So what is, let us know more about this. What exactly is paravidya and what exactly is aparavidya? So here, the philosophy of Vedic education is speaking about, is telling about paravidya and aparavidya. So let me first, again, repeat that. He who knows these two, paravidya and aparavidya together, crosses death through aparavidya and attains immortality through vidya. So this is the fundamental philosophy of So Vedic education, which we find in Vedic scriptures and Upanishads especially. So what is it? So paravidya is that knowledge which leads an individual to know about himself or herself, the knowledge of Atman, self or soul, which we call. So it is all knowledge that makes an individual or student to live in harmony with oneself. And the knowledge with which one can attain immortality, mukti or moksha, or getting rid of the cycle of birth and death is all about paravidya. So the famous conversation between Nachiketa and Yama, which comes in the Upanishads, was in fact about this knowledge of paravidya. And our greatest and revered Rishi of our times, Swami Vivekananda, spoke about this knowledge of paravidya in his many lectures in Vedanta philosophy. So this is about paravidya. Since I'm just speaking in general about what exactly is paravidya, so next we'll speak about how we are going to achieve all this. So what is aparavidya? So the knowledge which helps an individual to cross the ocean of life or samsara. So what is that? The knowledge which helps an individual to perform day-to-day activities of the life skillfully. The knowledge which helps an individual to earn his or her living. In fact, our present modern education system can be said to be more focused on aparavidya and almost nil on paravidya. Let me elaborate. So whatever skills, whatever knowledge which any individual acquires during his stay in schooling or Gurukula or whatever, which makes him to earn his living, which makes him to move around in the worldly life, is all about aparavidya. So we can say our present modern education system can be said to be more focused on aparavidya and almost nil on paravidya. Next, we are going to speak about the acharya. Excuse me, ma'am. I'll just. I'll just join you in a minute.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Yeah, the next comes the acharya. What is expected from an acharya from the reference of the Vedas or Shastras? So it says, acharya upanayamano brahmacharinam krinute garbhamantahatam pratrishtishtam udare vibhartitam jatam tushnam avimashyanti deva. The Atharva Veda says like this. What is it? So acharya symbolically takes the student into his womb, where he keeps him for 3 nights. And when that child comes out, even the devatas crave to see him. So that is what expected from an acharya. So he is so acharya is such a noble soul. The word acharya is such a noble soul where he actually takes the boy as his own child, and he is visualizing and keeping, and he is keeping in his mind, and then he is actually making a sankalpa to give a very good noble soul to the society through his teachings of his knowledge and other things. And his acharana. So another quality is achinotihi shastrani achare sthapayantipi swayamacharate chaiva tasmad acharya prachakshate. So it says, learner and scholar, an acharya is the one who lives as he preaches. So a student will look at what he is actually living. So whatever he is preaching, he is living. This is one of the noble quality which is expected from an acharya. This is one of the references from our shastras. The next is qualities expected from a brahmachari or a student. During Upadesha given to brahmacharis during Snataka Sambarambha gives us this actual reference of what is expected from a student who is passing out from a Gurukula. It says, Vedamano Charyon Devasina Manushasti, having taught the Veda, the teacher instructs the pupil, Satyam Vada, speak the truth, Dharmam Chara, practice virtue. Swadhyaya anma pramadaha, do not neglect your daily study. Acharyaya priyadhanuman dhanamahrutya, offer to the teacher whatever pleases him. Prajatantum mavyavachetsi, do not cut off the line of progeny. Satyanna pramaditavyam, do not neglect truth. Dharma anna pramaditavyam, do not neglect virtue. Kushala anna pramaditavyam, do not neglect welfare. Bhute anna pramaditavyam, do not neglect prosperity. Swadhyaya pravachana abhyanna pramaditavyam, do not neglect study and teaching, in fact self-study. Deva Pitru Karya Abhyana Pramaditavyam, do not neglect your duty towards gods and ancestors. Matru Devo Bhava, regard the mother as your god. Pitru Devo Bhava, regard the father as your god. Acharya Devo Bhava, regard the teacher as your god. Atithi Devo Bhava, regard the guest as your god. Yanyanavadhyani karmani, tani sevitavyani, no itarani, whatever deeds are blameless, they are to be practiced and not others. Yadnyasmakajam sucharitani, tani tvayopasyani, no itarani, whatever good practices are among us are to be adopted by you, not others. It says, Eke charumache yaso brahmana teshantvayosanena prachvasitavyam. Brahmins and those superior to us should be honored by you by offering a seat. It says, Eke charumache yaso brahmana teshantvayosanena prachvasitavyam. Brahmins and those superior to be offering a seat. Shraddhaya deyam, you with faith. Ashraddhaya deyam, you even if you do not have faith. Shriya deyam, you in plenty. Riya deyam, you at least for the sake of shame. Bhiya deyam, you with fear. Samvida deyam, you with knowledge. So this is it is also saying about giving, the noble act of giving. Next, atayadide karma vichikitsava vrutta vichikitsava syat etatra brahmanaha sammarshinaha yukta ayuktaha aloksha dharma kamasyuhu Tate tatra varteran, tata tatra varteta. As the Brahmins who are competent to judge, adept in duty, not led by others, not harsh, not led by passion in the manner they would behave, thus should you behave. So it is saying, so our behavior should be, if anybody is unable to behave, how I should behave in a very complex situations where I cannot judge. So you should judge how the Brahmins should behave. Where they are adept in duty, not led by others. They are not led by any others. Such people are said to be, we need to be followed. We need to follow such people who are not being led by anybody. So they are not harsh, not led by passion. So, atabhya ketush khyatesho etatra brahmanaha sammarshinaha yukta ayukta aloksha dharma kamasyuho etate teshu varteran tata teshu vartetaha. So again it says, so how to behave with the persons who are accused of guilt. So again it says, like the Brahmins who are adept at deliberation, who are competent to judge, not directed by others, not harsh, not moved by passion, as they would behave in such cases, thus should you behave. So these are all some of the instructions and given to the Snataka when he is coming out of his Gurukula, where he need to behave and he need to act in the particular society. Esha adeshaha. This is the command. Esha upadeshaha. This is the teaching. Esha Veda Upanishad. This is the secret doctrine of the Veda. Etadanushasanam. This is the instruction. Evam upasitavyam. Thus should one worship. Thus should evam uchaitad upasyam. Thus indeed should one worship. This is what? The instruction which is given to a student when he is going out of the Gurukula and when he is becoming a Snataka. So now we can understand how a man who is going into the society is actually being expected of what his acts and deeds are concerned. Next, we'll go to the ideal atmosphere. It says, Upahvare girinam sangathecha nadinam dhiya vipro jayata. So what does it mean? Where the hills and mountains all around and the confluence of two rivers is the most conducive place for the formation of enlightened souls. So such is the place where enlightened souls comes out. So this is what our Vedas say about the environment of an ideal Gurukula. So, in fact, we are proud to say that this, our Om Shanti Dhamma Veda Gurukula, is situated on Sangama near Kanakpura Taluk, Ramnagara district, which is 90 kilometers from Bangalore, is situated on the banks of the river Kaveri on such ideal location. So, a brief background to Om Shanti Dhamma Gurukul, how it all started. In the year 1989, a group of like-minded individuals inspired by the precepts of the Vedas decided to start a Gurukul. After searching thousands of kilometers for an ideal location as per the specification as mentioned in the Vedas to start an ideal Gurukul, they found such a location near Sangama on the banks of the river Kaveri. So that is a confluence of river Kaveri and Arkavati, 90 kilometers from Bangalore. What are the objectives of Om Shanti Dham? That is to preserve and propagate the importance and sanctity of the Vedas and also to practice the culture, tradition and values enshrined in the Vedas through Gurukula system of education and to enable them to acquire knowledge of modern disciplines like science, mathematics and humanities. To conduct variety of short-term, long-term Vedic educational programs for general public. to revive, rehabilitate, rejuvenate, and restore Shrauta traditions. I'll tell more about this. Just a couple of lines about what is Shrauta tradition. And then to create a platform for Vedic scholars and scientists to discuss the relevance of the Vedas in modern times through seminars, symposiums, study circles, and etc. To provide medical services to rural poor around the campus of Om Shantidham. These are some of the objectives of Om Shantidham Charitable Trust and Om Shantidham. So, of course, to plant trees, medicinal plants, and herbs on the land around Om Shantidham. So, what is the admission process? We do Upanayana and Vedarambha Sanskar to all the children, irrespective of caste and creed, and it is open to all. And this is the admission process, one of the admission process which we follow, that is Upanayana and Vedarambha Sanskar to all the children who are entering our Gurukula. So what are some of the infrastructure at Om Shantidham? So this is our Bhojan Shala. So modern education block, that is classrooms. Goshala, we have Goshala. Children do Goseva. So this is about infrastructure. Next. So how they are being, what is the Dinacharya of their students. So this is the mantra to be recited in the morning after they wake up.
Some of you are not hearing them, the student recitation. Pramodji, we are not able to hear the children, the mantra.
Oh, I see. 1 second.
Yeah.
You are not able to hear, right, ma'am?
Yeah, we are not able to hear. We are not able to hear it.
Oh, yeah. One second. Now? Next is Sandhya Vandana. Are you able to hear the audio of the slides, ma'am? The video?
Yes.
Okay. That we are okay. One second. Next is Sandhya Vandana. So after they wake up, so they do yoga and pranayama. So after the brief washings, they'll do the Sandhya Vandana. One second. So the next one is after Sandhya, all the children will participate in the Agni Karya, that is Agnihotra. So this is after their breakfast. So morning Gurukula prayer it is.
Shama
Eva
Vanasaja
Eva
Prathana.
Vedic class.
Devasya tvasa vitu prasave
devasya tvasa vitu
prasave devasya tvaha vidu prasave
asvina arbahu bhyam
asvina arbahu bhyam asvina arbahu bhyam
ushna hasta abhyamadate
ushna hasta
So the next one is, we also do, our Gurukula has also got a scholar in Paniniya Vyakarana who can teach Paniniya Vyakarana.
Upadishta se sunte inka upadesh nahi kiya kahin par bhi a e un rilde ka aadmi kahin upadesh kiya nahi kiya na fir bhi ye jo hai श्रूयन्ते ये सुनाई देते हैं तो इस प्रकार से इनको अयोगवाह ऐसा कहते हैं तो सबसे पहले देखते हैं विसर्जनीय ये तो सब जानते ही हैं सर्वेभ्यो नमः जब बोलते हैं तो नमः में जो विसर्ग लगाते हैं वो विसर्ग उसके बाद जिह्वा मूलीय कहाँ होता है क ख कहाँ पर होता है क ख यदि विसर्ग के बाद में आने पर विसर्ग है यही विसर्ग के बाद का ख आ गया तो तब वो विसर्ग क्या हो जाता है ऐसा हो जाता है हाँ इसका उच्चारण का भी विषय भी देखते हैं जैसे कोई उदाहरण है रामः करोति रामः करोति तो यहाँ पर आपको क्या है दो तरह से उच्चारण कर सकते हैं एक तो विसर्ग का उच्चारण करोगे तो रामः करोति ठीक है अगर जिह्वा मूलीय का उच्चारण करोगे तो रामः करोति रामः करोति तो विसर्ग को ही बोलना है आपको रामः करोति क को थोड़ा सा उसका भी थोड़ा इसमें आ जाएगा क एक और क जैसे रामः करोति ठीक है ऐसे ही ख का उदाहरण देखते हैं रामः खादति ले सकते हो खनति ले सकते हो खनति मतलब खोदता है राम खोदता है तो राम खनति अब विसर्ग बोलेगा तो राम खनति अलग अलग बोलेगा नहीं तो राम खनति राम खनति तो ये हो गया जिह्वा मूलीय अब ये देखते हैं उपद्मानी उपद्मानी कब आता है जब प और
So this is typical classrooms there. This is the where after their classes they do bhojana. So I'll also make you to listen the bhojana mantra recited. So this is the mantra recited after food if you want to listen.
Once again.
how do we implement this Vedic philosophy of education? Gurukula is an ideal atmosphere where Gurukula, where children live and study in an environment free from all bad influences of modern day world, which gives them ample opportunity to develop a contemplative mind. The dinacharya or daily routine also helps to achieve the objective. The sattvic food, the regular satsangs and knowledge sessions from learned scholars who visit Gurukula on a regular basis. This is how the features of the pillars of ancient Gurukula system of education, so which we are striving. The curriculum also, which is equipped with modern education, so children study state board education along with, of course, the Rigveda, Yajurveda. So we have Rigveda and Yajurveda and Sanskrit Vena, Sanskrit Vakarna will help him to acquire all the required skills to live in a modern world. So some of the our Vedic students are also being honored from renowned personalities from many parts of the world. They are being invited to honor our Snatakas who have successfully completed the Vedic studies. Some of the alumni of Gurukula, Om Shantidam, what they are doing, many are Vedic scholars, Sanskrit scholars, lecturers in Sanskrit universities, some are yoga trainers in India and abroad, some are chartered accountants, some are engineers, some are doctors, some are also scientists, some spiritual heads of mutts, and many other areas of professions. This is some of the brief background of what our alumni are doing now. Media has also been covering our Gurukula from past few years on a regular basis. So this is in 2003, where Chaturvedi, who was the then governor of Karnataka, also visited. This is one of the newspapers. So this is in Time magazine in US. Also, Gurukula, our children doing yoga is also being published there in the Time magazine. So this is one of the media coverage. Then comes, just want to speak about Shrauta and Somayagas. So Om Shantidama has also been protecting and reviving our ancient yaga, that is Shrauta Yaga, not Smarta Yaga. This is called Shrauta Yaga, where Tretagni will be there, Dakshinagni, Ahavani, and Garhapatya. So this is a Tretagni. So it is purely a Shrauta Yaga, that is Vedic Yaga. Om Shantidama is being associated with other organizations and to revive this tradition, ancient tradition, till 2020, before the corona. So some Agnihotris are also coming to Om Shantidama Gurukund and also doing Somayagas with Garuda Chaina are also being performed. So Om Shantidama is putting has been associating with reviving this ancient tradition. So this is what I can, this is what a brief introduction about Gurukula system of education, which Lalita ma'am also spoke to me few days back, and she requested me to speak on this. If anybody wants to ask any question and what I spoke, so I'm ready to share whatever knowledge.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pramodji. You have really delivered really a mind-blowing presentation, because it really was something, we felt we were in a Vedic Pathshala ourselves. We could feel it. It was really something, you know, it is mind blowing. Now I request all the participants here, they all have been yearning for a Veda, to know more about Vedic Pathshala and teaching Veda, the methods of teaching Veda in the present day academic systems, schooling system. So correct. I found yours was a model, you know, when this topic came, you know, when the people were wanted to know more about it, that's when I told about Om Shanti Dhamma, the service you are rendering to the community and to the society and country and globally also. So you have really come and done that. You have presented about it. Now I request the participants to raise their hand. I'll unmute. And then, you know, you can have an interaction with Mr. Pramod ji. Please. Linga Reddy Garu, you can ask first.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It is very good. Same idea I have. So now my question is, the admission is allowed to everyone. Is there any basic rules are there?
It is open to all, sir. Fourth to fifth standard, whoever student who has passed fourth and also fifth and even sixth as well. So we will encourage to take admission. So seventh onwards, if he is really keen on Vedas, he can definitely take admission. Of course, there'll be a selection camp, which will be conducted in Gurukula to see the aptitude of the child, whether he is really interested, because with the force of parents he has come, that will be observed there. Our teachers and acharyas, they'll conduct the test about 3 to 4 days. And if he is selected, we will inform the parents that he is selected. If you are interested, you can enroll the child. So education is totally free.
Okay. Thank you. Oh, great. Thank you so much.
Linga Reddy Garu, and it's an I would like to tell all those present, if they want to join, the Google form is available with Veda Samskruti Samiti. Okay. We'll give you the form also, application form, if anybody is interested. And we will also post it in our groups. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Yes, next it is Ratnamala ji, please.
Namaste, Pramod ji. Namaste. It was a very good information that you have shared with us. My doubt was, are girls also taken into the Gurukuls?
No, right now it is only for boys, ma'am. It is only for boys.
Oh, okay.
Some of the girls were early. It started with the girls' Gurukula. Now it is being stopped, and now it is only for boys, ma'am.
Okay, that was my doubt. Thank you.
Okay. Next, Ramaya ji, please.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, sir.
You are doing a very great job, actually.
Yes, sir. Many
and
people
are loving our ancient.
Many seniors and many elders who have started this, and we are just representing them.
Oh, whatever. You are carrying on this one. A noble job. Right. But I was wondering, actually, you are taking care of this Vedic knowledge, Vedic philosophy. Apart from this, you are doing the current, knowledge also, so that the students are equipped on either side, so that they can go for the living.
Correct.
Of course, people who are keen, they will go for the spreading of Sanskrit and setting our religion, Hindu religion and all, that is one side. But others will go for the normal jobs. So the curriculum or syllabus, what you follow, is it the same state government or central government or CBSE you follow it, so that they will be able to face the examinations and pass?
Yes, for Vedic education, we have Maharshi Sandipini Vedavidya Pradishtan syllabus, sir. They have set proper guidelines for what first year certain suktas are to be recited and learned. So that syllabus is being followed for Vedic education. For modern education, we follow Karnataka State Board syllabus, sir. Since it is in Karnataka, so we follow Karnataka State Board syllabus. Science, maths, social, English, mathematics. So all the subjects are being taught along with the Vedic education in the morning. And in the afternoon, it will be general education, modern education.
Up to what standard you are teaching in this school?
It is up to 10th standard, sir.
up to 10th. They, 10th they will pass out and then go.
If they are interested to continue with Vedic studies, they can continue. Stay there and continue Vedic studies, sir.
I see, I see. That's a great, very great initiative, sir. Really, you are doing a noble job. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Padma Priya Garu, it's you.
Yeah, thank you, Andi. Namaste. Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Sir, I have a small doubt. Yeah. I'm a teacher by profession. I'm in this profession since 2012.
Okay.
Prior to that, I was into banking sector.
Okay.
So my doubt is, this is only for students, right? Small children.
Yes, I mean, from fourth, after fourth passed, they can enroll.
Okay. Is after, there anything?
After 10th also, if he wants to study Vedas, they can, the child can come, ma'am. We'll analyze the child, and if he is very keen on learning Vedas, he can come after 10th also.
Is it only for boys, not for adult people, women?
Right now, if you, for a short term, you can stay, anybody can come. We'll just come and stay there and then learn. And
okay.
Learn the Vedas.
So how can we approach you if I'm interested?
I have shared my emails, ma'am.
I'll give that Padma Priya Garu with Veda Samskrit Samthi, and we have it with us. We'll give all the details. Okay.
We'll post okay. It. Yeah. Thank you.
Next, anybody else who wants to talk to Mr. Pramod ji, know more about the Vedic Pathshala?
Namo Namaha Mahode, yes. Mahodaya.
Yes.
I'm offering my pranams to you.
Yes.
Actually,
yes.
I just missed the timing. I just joined late. What is it? Boarding by boarding the child.
Yes. It is a residential school. It is a residential
school.
Residential Gurukula.
Gurukula. And yeah. Some years back, my brother was wanting to put his child in Gurukula, and we were all we sisters were not agreeing with that. But I feel the need, and I also realized that the older form of education enables the child to think beyond the normal education we have as of now. So it is only at the younger age you offer for children, right? We cannot have older children in your...
Right now we do not have for older children, but some one or two older children also do come and stay there to learn Vedas, ma'am. It is only till 10th standard. But most of them will go out and pursue their own college studies and other Sanskrit related studies outside the Gurukul. Some few wants to come after 10th and stay there. There are quite a few children, or 4 or 5 children there in our Gurukul.
Okay. After 10th, till 10th, they'll be taking up the Vedic studies. After 10th, they'll be that empowered to choose their own branch, right? They don't require this 11th, 12th standard college studies or the typical way of education. They'll be empowered with yes. knowledge that they can foresee their future in such a way, right?
Yes, ma'am, yes. That's the fact, ma'am. So One of our students, he's very keenly pursuing his Sanskrit related studies. And of course, he's writing their own concerned examinations to get a societal recognition related to Sanskrit and Vedic field. So which we will encourage him and motivate the students there.
Okay.
Devan, please, it's your turn.
Dhanyavada, Mahodaya. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, namaskar, sir.
Yeah, namaskar.
My name is Rajesh Kumar, and I have a daughter.
Okay.
She's Devanshi. She's going to be 7 by March 30th. Mm. And we have one class in a week offline, online, sir, for girls.
That we are actually thinking on those lines. So we have some connectivity issues there till to, from past few years, sir. We had a BSNL network connection, sir. So now, after Corona, nothing is moving. No activities were moving related to connectivity issues. So now I think there is a possibility that the Gurukula will be connected online with proper network facilities, internet facilities. So then we'll get back to you, sir. We will please be in touch.
Yes, so sir.
We'll get back to you. That, we'll have that a separate online enrollment.
Yes, once in a week, 2 hours class or 1.5 hour class, yeah, 90 minutes class.
Yeah.
That will be great for the girls and, you know, to learn.
Correct,
like
correct.
She's going to be 7 and that tender age. She knows many shlokas. I tried my best to teach her. Mm-hmm. But the way it comes from Gurukula is an impact for the lifetime.
Right.
Parents sikhaye to jaldi chale jata kabhi kabhi.
Mm-hmm.
But Gurukula impact and, you know, the flow of from a religious institutions, that is, which I feel should be blessed, blessing for children.
Mm-hmm.
We'll definitely try. Yeah, we'll plan it. Rajesh Kumarji, we'll plan it, and where is Sanskrit Samiti, we'll organize the online sessions also in consultation with Om Shanti Dhamma in the near future. We'll have a deliberation in this. Yes, ma'am. I really look forward to see that. Yeah, we'll all do. May the Almighty bless. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for giving me time.
Thanks.
Anybody else who wants to know something? I think Kocharla Kota, VRS Murthy, sir. You were reported in our last meeting.
I think. Our Padmashri madam is also there. So if anybody wants to ask, she is one of our MC member, management committee member. She's also vice president of the Sveta Pathshala.
Now, Vivek ji, you please, you have raised your hand. You please ask.
I'm Vivek Gar from Ujjain. I just want to know that this Gurukul is affiliated to the Rishi Sandipni Rishi Sandipni board, which is his office is in Ujjain, I think so.
Yes, yes. Actually, Vedic syllabus is being the Vedic syllabus which we follow is affiliated to Ujjain, sir. Okay. And modern education we follow state board, sir, Karnataka state board. And okay. Gurukula is been running, I mean going on from past 23 years, sir.
Okay.
Recently, the Vedic syllabus is being affiliated to the Ujjain, so that there has to be a structured, format where the students and the teachers also know what exactly to teach and what is the expected outcome for about in a year. So those structured format is being followed from Sandeepini, Ujjain.
Okay. Second thing, I just want to know that.
Yes,
some of my friends are trying to open some gurukuls in the different parts of India.
Okay.
And there are also some, like the Ankush Bhandari is one of my NRI friends. He's funding nearly 9 schools around the India.
Mm-hmm.
So many, they are from the organization of the Kohona. He's one of the founder members.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to know that how many gurukuls are actually listed out, because some are running because of the short of the funds, some gurukuls get closed.
Hmm.
So is there any comprehensive mechanism program that how to manage these gurukuls?
Mm-hmm.
The government or some kind of the organizations are helping them out. Is there any plan?
Please You can email us detailed proposals.
Yeah, we can have a separate
meeting with regard to this. So we can, some of our students, alumni, wants to start a Gurukul, our older children. So they, you can, we can get them connected to such
definitely
philanthropists who can fund and can sponsor.
So where are the emails you are giving in the group or somewhere?
Yeah, we'll give it, Vivek ji. It is there with Vedsamskrutsamthi. We'll give it to you. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Next, Venugopal Reddy ji. You.
Sir, good evening, sir. Thanks, ma'am.
Yeah, please tell me, sir. Tell me.
Sir, what are the strength of the students, sir? And
right now we have 70 students, sir.
Sir, what are the dropout percentage, sir? In general. How many will there be?
Dropout is less than 5%, sir. And less most contest, likely, sir. Most likely we only ask them to leave if the child is really not keen on studying. The child must have come for in with the pressure from the parents. So very choosingly we'll choose the children.
Anything below 10%, 20% is outstanding, sir.
Right.
Dropout. That means the consistency is very good.
The infrastructure, you know, sir, it is a very systematic. They have a proper set of hostels. So it's children go to Bhojan Shala. They take breakfast, snacks being provided in the evening. Milk is provided from the Goshala. So children would not like to go out. That's what
the last two things, sir. What are the parents' feedback, sir? After these people completed
Parents are very happy. Parents are very happy, sir. As far as we know, otherwise they won't allow us to allow the children there. They'll take out the children from there. It's not anybody's.
Fantastic, sir.
Sandeep ji, please. Uh-huh. 3469. I want to know the name because with the number and all, can you please tell your name? So I'll unmute you also. Please, I'll unmute you, but please tell your name and then start this one, sir. Now it's Sandeep ji. Afterwards, the name, the number person. Yeah. Sandeep ji, you please continue.
Namo Namo Mahoday. I am Colonel Sandeep Sharma, Indian Army. I'm posted at Varanasi.
Okay.
And it was nice knowing what you are doing. And I had a couple of doubts what is the percentage of syllabus that you are covering from the local board syllabus, and how much percent is that Ujjain Wala board? How much of that, what is the percentage?
It is 100% from Vedic syllabus, and most likely 90% with regard to modern education, sir. 80 to 90%.
No, what I mean is a typical student in a day, how much percent of his time he devotes for the Ujjain syllabus? How much for your local syllabus?
4 hours for Vedic and 3 hours for modern education. So 2.5 hours for general education.
2.5 for a general education is enough?
Yes, good enough, sir. 40 minutes time to four periods.
And they prepare for their various competitive exams also.
Not competitive exams, sir.
You said many of them, they have become doctors and engineers, you said.
After 10th, they must have pursued the other CBSE or PUC, the state board 11th and 12th, sir.
So you are guiding them only up to 10th?
Up board. To 10th standard, sir. Not competitive.
And my second thing is...
Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
My second thing is, supposing I want to start something like this at Varanasi.
Okay.
Supposing then, how do I go about it? What are the governmental support I can get? And what are the NRIs? Do you have any list of NRIs who will be more than happy to sponsor my project? Something like that.
Have a separate meeting for
separate.
Because, this session is only about Shantidhama. And he will guide you in the next session. We'll arrange another session. Where, you know, we can have a deliberative session and interactive about how to set up a Gurukula. This is only about their present operation.
Yes,
About admissions. Yeah.
Yes.
Let us, please.
You can get in touch with our Lalita ma'am. And also I have given a contact email ID there. below.
Okay. So we'll provide you all that information, sir, please. Now it is 346920. I don't know the name, sir, please. I'll unmute you. You just tell your name and then,
Namaskar, Sarvebhya. My name is Kasiraj Padmavati.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Okay. Chappandi.
My husband also having the same idea, ma'am. After retirement, he also wants to open Vedic Parshala. So he wants some guidelines regarding that.
Surely, ma'am. We can.
We'll arrange a next session, Veda Samskrit Samthi. Okay. We'll arrange the sessions and there you can get to know more about it, Padmavati.
Okay. Before that, we want to have some knowledge regarding this. So, can we have any online records or can we listen or get some any online classes?
Padmaji, one second. For that, you know, we are very specific. I think they are not going to provide such classes because theirs is an organization. So, through Veda Samskriti Samthi, see, we can have interactive meetings, that's all. It can't be online, they'll show their documents. This is not, because it is an organization by itself. They will show some documentary. They can't teach all this, right? So we'll have interactive sessions. You know, now it's not the time for that. This one. Veda Samskriti Samthi will organize on similar lines. Please understand. Yeah, next, anybody else who has, somebody else, two more people are. Yeah, I think again Sandeep ji wants to ask something.
No, my whatever I had already asked.
Okay. Thank you.
I was told those clarification will be given to me.
Yeah, we'll give it to you later. We'll give it to you. Anybody else who wants to have any clarification from Pramod ji?
Anything else which I spoke today, the fundamental pillars of the Gurukula is being followed, and the Dinacharya that is being followed. If you want any specific questions on that, so such things, if you are keen on that, to know anything, such questions you can ask, because the session is regarding the Gurukula and Om Shantida. Of course, the future projects which you want to conceive and visualize, that we will definitely have a separate interactive session.
We'll arrange such sessions with something we'll arrange in the forthcoming series. We can have a series of such sessions. If there are no more questions or queries to be raised, I think I'll ask our Vice President, Dr. Vishalakshi ji, to take over.
Himakanti is waving his.
Sure. I'll just one second.
He wants to ask some question.
Swagatam Pramod Kumar ji, I am the president of this Vedasam Samthi.
Actually, because sir's name was different, you know, I wasn't able to recognize. Good you told.
My name is Prabhakar Rao.
Yes, sir. Nice meeting you. Nice seeing you, sir. Nice seeing you.
I am overwhelmed by your presentation. It's an excellent presentation.
Thank you very much.
This is what I'm expecting. This type of presentation only I'm expecting for a Gurukula system of education. Mm-hmm. And the Vedasam Samithi is the main motto is this only. Mm-hmm. We are propagating this type of education should be there last 1 year. The first session of this webinar session started with the education system only. And I was promoting from that time onwards, telling people to start this type of education schools. And I'm very happy to know that is already one school is running last 15 years. And our Vedasam Samithi is committed to support this type of setups and other things. And whatever we are theoretically talking is practically going on there. That's what I felt. And I'm very much happy to see that something is practically happening, what I am thinking. So this type of education system should be promoted. And as our Lalitaji told, our secretary Lalitaji told, we will definitely give a support to you, and we will support the other people also who are interested to start new education systems like this, new schools.
Correct.
And whatever is required, we can act as a supporting organization for these type of education systems. That's what I want to put forward and inform to all the people concerned, Mr. Sandeep and others. And let us promote this type of schools. And I was trying to do, I was also somebody from Ongole, Geeta Lakshmi, I don't know whether she is there. I was also somebody from Lena, Bharati Vidya Bhavan from Pune.
Geeta Ji has not come.
Yeah, Venugopal Reddy is also a person who is having education system only, I hope. And all these people are in education system. Many people have sent the messages to them who are in education system. And I hope this type of Gurukula should continue and should be increase in number of times. Better you give another session to us whereby new entrants, what are the facilities they should create, what type of infrastructure they should create, what type of minimum requirements to start. Correct. Any school.
Correct.
And, what would be the expenditure patterns, what are the problems you have, how to tackle them. On this, if you can give another lecture, that will be better, I think.
Sure, sir. We'll do that in the future, sir.
And as a franchise, see, the Reliance Industries, when they started, they got only one factory. They have gone.
Correct, sir. This is a movement. This is.
Yeah, and they arranged the franchise of these shops. Thousands and thousands of ML sales started this thing. That's how the mass movement can be done, only by that type of things, franchise system.
Right, sir. So once upon a time, we had 6 lakhs Gurukulas in in India, sir, as per the records.
Some institution is there in Chennai. Some gentleman was there. I invited him also. I don't know whether he has come here. And they're also having some schools. Some 9 schools are there in South. And then somebody from Delhi, Paripurna Swami, is there, is having 9 schools all over India. So they're also running, Gurukula schools are there. But it has to, like a fire, it should go.
Correct.
So if that has to go, means there should be an organization by which this franchise system can be adapted. I created a concept document, what a management should think of, what a teacher should think of, what a parent should think of. And how to be a teacher, how what is the training to be given to the teachers to make a Sanskrit medium Gurukula system of education. A concept document I made, but I could not proceed further on that. Still some lacunas are there for me. So based that, my interest was to that concept document. I can share with you also if you are interested.
Sure, sir. You can definitely.
What are the that gives a concept to the education system management, what you should have to promote this type of school. And that gives a concept document to a parent, what type of thinking you should have to tell this thing. And there should be another concept document, what a teacher should be there and how he should behave in the school.
Correct.
What type of the way, how he should behave. So these are the 3 important organizations, and 4th is student anyway.
Correct.
So these are the 4 important elements that we should think of on these things. And all the 4 sections, I have prepared the concept document, but that is I stopped there only. I have to promote that. So there's still work is going on that. So if I can associate you, the Vyasam Samiti will be fully in support to you. Whatever work we can do, please advise us as a focal point, as a publishing point.
Sure, sir.
Support you. And I understand your vice president is also there.
We'll be
happy if she also can share news with us. Yeah,
one of our founder member, I think Mr. Satyavrata is also one of the founders of this Gurukula.
Yeah, he's there. I'll unmute him.
Yeah, please unmute him.
Yeah. If they can also speak and share their views, we'll be very happy to associate.
Yes, sir. You unmute him, ma'am.
I'll unmute both Padmashree Garu and Satyavrata Rao. I have unmuted Satyavrata sir.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Please welcome. Please talk, sir. Achyuthi, sir.
Satyaji.
Swagatam. Please.
I think I'll just check. Hello? No.
She not unmuted. Her name was not unmuted. Sachivata Rao is not unmuted. She has to accept the...
They have to accept. They have to accept.
They have not accepted, I think, both of them.
That's okay. Yeah. That's Padmashri ma'am is unmuted, I think.
Yeah, she's unmuted.
Namaste to all.
Yeah. Swagatam, madam. Swagatam, madam. Please, Swagatam, Mahodaye. Please talk. Please share your views and guide us how we should go with you.
Sir, sir will be the best guy to tell everybody like how we can go forward, because he is the one who started this book like 27 years back.
Yeah.
Sir, once he unmutes, he'll explain. I can talk about this Ujjini scheme which we are having. We have about 7 years course which is prescribed by this Sandipni Vedavidya Pratishthan. That makes the child become eligible to join a graduation after 7 years of this. It is equivalent to 12th standard, where they are given 2 years of Veda Vibhushan. That's a 2 years course after 5 years of Veda Vibhushan. And Government of India has recognized about 16 universities where they can join to pursue their graduation of these humanity subjects like Sanskritam, Vyakarana, Yoga, Psychology, all the things. So most of our children are now who have finished up to Veda Bhushan are doing Veda Vibhushan. They're also doing from Tirupati Prakshastri courses also. Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidya Pita. So those children are eligible to get the degree from there or anywhere else. This is what I can talk about. Maybe Satyaj sir will be able to tell more about how to start.
I have asked him to unmute himself. I have sent a message. And by the way, Padmashri madam, if I have to tell, her husband is a retired IIM professor. And they have dedicated their lives for this, and they are doing so much of service for Om Shanti Dham. In fact,
great job, ma'am.
Yeah, we are friends and we know each other well. That is why I have
done.
Yeah.
Pranam, Shriyu.
Thanks to you, sir. Thanks.
Satyavrata ji.
Amma.
Satyavrata ji, Garu.
Satyaj sir, achara.
No, I think he's I don't know what is okay, fine, ma'am. Next, we'll have yes, sir.
Padmashri madam and Pramod ji, we are very much interested to support you, to associate with you. Whatever help we can do, please advise us, please order us rather.
Sure, sir. Sure, in fact, Padmashri madam has asked that there's this one good. Group which is Veda Samskruti group which wants to know more about Gurukul. She actually asked me to okay ma'am with if you're telling we'll do. She in fact pushed me to present this is my in fact first presentation with regard to
it's a great presentation. I request something addition to this is you some interaction with students, some interaction with teachers. Kindly arrange what are their views and how they are behaving. And some alumni candidate. If you add that also to this, it will be a great presentation. It will be a great.
If it will be good if one of few members of yourself, your group can visit Gurukul. We invite you to go visit Gurukul. Maybe after coming days, maybe in the month of May or whenever is convenient for all of you to visit Gurukul and interact with the children. We invite there instead of online.
No, that's correct. That is one way. Anyway, who is interested to start a school, he has to come and see and take guidance from him. That will happen. But what I'm saying, for the presentation sake, if you give the views of one or two students, one or two alumni, one or two teachers, if we add that also, we give more highlight to the presentation. That's what I'm saying.
Sure, sir. We will make an arrangement of such kind. Definitely.
Yeah, we can have in the forthcoming sessions, one or two sessions. We'll plan the series of such Gurukula this one. And also, Mahodaya, our Sanskrit Bharati president, Prabhakar Shastri Garu, wanted to visit also. No? When I told on that day in the meeting about Om Shanti Dhamma, he said he would like to visit when he goes to Bangalore.
Oh, I guess.
Yes.
Yeah, so they all would like to visit. They have already expressed that they want to visit.
Let them contact with priorly.
Yeah, we'll give the details. Something we'll provide the details.
Yes.
So we have got some senior people in the group. Yeah, they want to share their opinion. And there is Prahlad Kumar Garu. Prabhu Garu has come, madam.
Prabhu Garu has not come, but Srikantham Prahlad Kumar Garu unnaru. Kocharla Kota KVS Shastri
Murthy Garu, Prahlad Kumar Garu, kindly share your views. Our advisors are there in the group here. Senior advisors Prahlad Kumar Garu and KVRS Murthy Garu, ISR KVRS Murthy Garu, and so many other people are also there in the group. I would like to request them to share their views also. Murthy Garu, KVRS Murthy Garu, Prahlad Kumar Garu, please.
They are gone, sir. They are not to be seen. Yeah, they are not to be seen.
So probably they have left. Okay. So,
Shastri Garu is
very, very, very. Who is that?
BVK Shastri Garu.
Yeah, BVK Shastri Garu. Would like to say he is from Vijayanagaram or Rajahmundry or something. He is a Veda Pandit probably. Shastri Mahodaya, would you like to speak? Meer maatladukunnara Shastri Garu, BVK Shastri Garu.
And BST Satya Garu unnaru. I have unmuted him also.
Unmute chesandi.
Some Nagalakshmi is
andarni Bharati chesandi, andarni Bharati chesandi. Everybody cannot know how to do unmute and all those things.
Mahodaya, I'll unmute all if anybody wants to.
Yeah. అన్మ్యూట్ చేసి మాట్లాడండి ఎవరైనా మాట్లాడాలనుకుంటే.
సార్, గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ టు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ.
Yes, sir.
I am Raghavendra from Bengaluru. Nice to join and listen to all of you.
Yes,
sir. And I am into education language teaching the children of 9th and 10th of ICSE and CBSE. Very happy to listen to this program. And I don't want to take much of your time. Please include my name for any future further interaction between all of you.
So, yeah, people who are not in my group, please leave your phone number and name and location. Please. I request all the people who are not in my group to give their phone number, name and location, so that I will be adding in my group, winner group, and I will be sending my messages to them. And I request all the people who to support this type of Gurukula system of education and support this type of organizations wherever they are. And we should have every district will have one Gurukula like this. Every district.
Sure, that's true, sir. That should happen.
Every district should have in the country.
Correct.
Namaste, Shastri Garu. Yeah. This is BVK Shastri from Bangalore. Can I speak?
Yeah, please. Yeah, but please, sir. BVK from Bangalore.
Venkat Krishna Shastri, aura.
How do?
Namaskara.
Satya Garu bartare anta helibittu, no, I was happy to listen to him. I wanted to listen to him. We have a good old connection. You know what I'm doing.
Yes.
So we can talk about it. Thanks for sharing the new presentation. Now we are having this Yoga Samstam University. We can also operate from a US base. We are in dialogue with SRIVT.
Sure, sir.
Sudhakar Shastri Garu will be able to make a better... for the proposal and that. Thank you. Thank you for the presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Very nice. Thank you, BVK Shastri Garu. Very nice that you have given your
We have our very good old associations with BVK Shastri, sir. We had started one higher learning center at his residence quite a few years back in Bangalore.
Okay.
So it was for adults. So now it's being stopped. That's this thing.
Connect back, I am at Bangalore.
Right. Okay. Sure, sir.
So, Pramodji, I would like to tell one more thing is that please share your bank details so that if anybody wants to donate from our group.
Sure, sir. We will, recently we have a QR code for our trust. So we'll also share all those details. We will share to Madam's Lalita.
So that whoever wants to donate, that they can donate to.
Yes. Yes.
Tan Man Dhan.
I'll do that.
These type of organizations will need Tan Man Dhan.
Yes, yes.
Whatever
yes.
they can do, they should support this organization. The country should come back to the original Gurukula system of education system.
Correct.
So now one second. Anybody else would like to speak?
Sir, can there be any presentation on how to start the Gurukula or how to know about it, where to have the information or see practically? I'm staying in Bangalore.
How to start a Gurukula? Of course, sir, mainly funds, land, and of course. So if you have that technical details, we can definitely provide, sir. So hardware should be ready. Software we can provide you, sir.
One more thing. What holds you to start a central syllabus? Why are the only state syllabus you are doing?
No, we have some children who are writing a National Institute of Open Schooling syllabus, sir. Some students also study NIOE syllabus. Some who are not from this local background, that is, they are from other states. They wish to go for NIOE. We'll give them options, sir.
Okay, but one more thing is this. The 70 number is so great in the present difficult situation, but that 70 type of thing should go to 7,000. How do you expect to make it?
No, 7,000 can happen at 7,000 different places, sir. I mean, at least 700 different places. So our Gurukula can have 100, maybe 120 students at a stretch. Right now, we have infrastructure up to 120 children, 100 to 120.
120 children you can take maximum. But in that
total. So we can take the more, 50 more, 30 to 50 more.
Okay.
Can
one more doubt I have is state governments will have a restriction that so much minimum candidate should be there to give recognize the school, recognize the syllabus, recognize the school. Like that type will not sufficient. The 70 is not sufficient for their recognition, right?
Yes, sir. But with the support of gracious people who are associated with our organization has made it happen that this can be recognized.
Is it recognized now, state government?
Yes. It is recognized. We have proper recognition from the state government syllabus, sir.
The document, the books, the state government books, normally we find in every school, the state government books are central government books. All are as per dharmic way of teachings are not there in that books, right? Regarding history, regarding the moral stories, they're all westernized moral stories, westernized things, not based on our cultural stories.
I agree that. I'm also
so how you are taking care of that content, how your content development you are doing in your books?
Right now, finer details we are not focusing, but we do have a proper planning where one of the research organization based in Bangalore who is doing research on developing textbooks. I am associated personally, so they wants to give that syllabus, and maybe we will. In future, we will implement that. Sir. Recently, it's been developed quite a couple of years back. So probably by next academic year, we may implement it, sir. Right now, that final details we are not focusing.
So we have to modify those contents.
Right. I agree, sir.
One is two ways I find this thing. One is charitra, wrong charitra reading. Second is the stories, moral stories and other things. They give the moral stories from the westernized syllabuses.
Correct.
Casabianca.
It is good that you have highlighted this point. I'll take note of it. And we should be very seriously, carefully see what our children are studying.
studying. So this, those stories, yes. Those stories should come from our
scriptures. Right. Scriptures. I understand. I fully agree with you, sir. It's a good, actually good amount of effort which we need to put in.
Do that. And in that respect, Mr. Chanchal Malavia from Pune is working on that. If you want, I can give his number to you. You can get associated with him also and take.
Sure.
This thing. So like that, we have to build up this. We have to build up this. I hope I request your management to take our support also, if what we can do.
And I think one of our student, Somshekhar Nagila, I will ask him to unmute. He is our alumni. I think he has started the Gurukul in his place. He is our alumni, actually. Om Shanti Dhamma's alumni. I will have asked him to unmute. Somshekhar.
Namaste. Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Yeah, please share your views.
Somshekhar, you can start.
ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ ಸರ್?
ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು.
ನೀವು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಮಿನಿಟ್. ಸರ್ವೇಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ನಾನು ಶಾಂತಿಧಾಮದಲ್ಲಿ 2003 to 2009
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸೋಮಶೇಖರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಂದಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಫಿಟ್ ತೆಲುಗು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ತೆಲುಗು ಮೆನಿ ಆರ್ also can understand Telugu.
Yeah, that is true. Kannada is
okay. I will go in Telugu only. Hindi so that all can understand.
That's fine.
Sabhi ko sadar namaste. Main jab 9 saal ka tha 2003 se 2009 tak meri 5vi kaksha se lekar 5th to 10th maine Shanti Dham mein hi pura kiya hu aur wahan par दोनों पढ़ाई हमारा चल रहा था. सुबह हम जो हमारा वैदिक एजुकेशन था, व्याकरण, भगवद गीता, ऋग्वेद, यजुर्वेद, ये चारों चलते थे. और दोपहर के बाद हमारा स्टेट सिलेबस, जो कि रिकॉग्नाइज्ड है स्टेट सिलेबस से, वो स्टेट सिलेबस हमारा चलता था दोपहर के बाद. तो उस तरह से हमने लगभग उस समय वहां पर जो 6 साल थे, उन 6 सालों में इन सबको हमने किया है. और मैं थोड़ा सा देर से ज्वाइन हुआ क्योंकि मुझे संदेश जो है तो अभी मिला था 2 मिनट पहले, तो मैं तुरंत उसमें अभी ज्वाइन हुआ था. तो अभी एक प्रश्न आया था बीच में, अभी सुन रहा था प्रमोद सर के साथ जब बात हो रही थी, कि जनरल स्टडीज जो हम पढ़ते हैं उसमें ऐसे विषय भी है जो कि हमारे सिद्धांत के या हमारे धर्म के अनुकूल नहीं है, प्रतिकूल है, या तो ऐसी बातें है जो कि हमारे वैदिक सिद्धांत के गलत हो सकता है, ऐसी बातें भी है, तो उसको हम किस तरह से उसको आप वहां पर बच्चों को बता रहे हैं. तो जैसे मैं वहां पर रहते हुए समझा हूं, क्योंकि मैं वहीं पर रहा हूं बचपन में पूरा 10वीं कक्षा तक, जो सिलेबस में होता था वो तो होता था, परीक्षा की दृष्टि से और अंकों की दृष्टि से, हमें तो मार्क्स की दृष्टि से जैसे पुस्तक में है वैसे ही लिखना पड़ता था. किंतु साथ में हम लोगों को जो हमारा पढ़ाने वाले थे, श्रद्धा भगिनी थे, सुविचार गुरु जी थे, नागराज भट्ट गुरु जी थे, कृष्ण भट्ट गुरु जी थे, ये सारे जो वेद हमें, वैदिक विद्या हमें पढ़ाते थे, वो हमें साथ में उसमें क्या सही है क्या गलत है उसकी विवेचना करने के अनुकूल बुद्धि हमारे दे दिए थे या समझ हमें आ गया था, क्योंकि हम साथ साथ में वेद भी पढ़ रहे थे और भारतीय इतिहास भी हमें वहां पर पता चलता था. और बड़े बड़े विद्वान गुरुकुल आते ही रहते थे लगातार, प्रति सप्ताह महीने में 2-3 तो अच्छे विद्वान आकर हमें उपदेश आदि देते थे, उससे भी काफी विषय पता चलता था. तो इस तरह से हमने वहां पर दोनों पढ़े. और दोनों पढ़ने के बाद हमें दोनों मार्गों में आगे जाने का मौका था 10वीं के बाद, उधर जनरल स्टडीज आगे बढ़ाना है या वैदिक बढ़ाना है. तो जिसको जो रुचि होती थी, जिसको जिसमें आगे बढ़ना था वो आगे बढ़े. तो सभी लगभग मेरे दृष्टि में अभी हमारे बैच तक का मुझे जानकारी है, क्योंकि उसके बाद का जानकारी अभी ज्यादा मेरे पास नहीं है. हमारे बैच तक का जितने भी लोगों को हमने देखा है सारे अच्छे सेटल्ड है, वेल सेटल्ड है और अच्छे मार्ग में है. कोई इंजीनियर है, कोई टेक्निकल साइड है, कोई सिक्योरिटी साइड है, कुछ जैसे मैं हूँ, कुछ हमारे जैसे है जो कि आगे जाकर व्याकरण महाभाष्य तक पढ़ लिए, फिर दर्शन श्रोत सूत्र आदि का अध्ययन करके अभी गुरुकुल आदि आगे चला रहे हैं। तो गुरुकुल में पढ़ने का या हम जो गुरुकुल में पढ़े उससे आगे का फ्यूचर का भी सोचने की तो आवश्यकता नहीं है जब हम दोनों तरह की विद्याएं वहां पर पढ़ते हैं। इतनी मैं कहना चाहूंगा।
So my last question is to Pramod ji is there.
Yes.
What is the level of Sanskrit at the end of the session of the student? What is the level of Vedas of the student? What is the level of this 10th class education system? So 10th class is easily go to intermediate anywhere, any college, you can easily go.
Yes, definitely. He can get through with first class distinction marks as per his abilities, and then get into the science stream, art stream, commerce stream, whatever he wants in the modern education field. In the Vedic field, he will be a Vedic scholar, Veda Pandit. He will be...
what he learned? At what level he learns? It will give
so there'll be the sutras, which, suktas which he learns in the Vedas, right? So it is in a Rigveda, there will be certain set of suktas. So in that Samhita Pata, Pada Pata, Krama Pata, I think till Krama Pata it is being done. The exact details, so we'll get in touch with our Vedic Pandits and the Acharyas and the teachers, Upadhyayas there in Gurukul.
So not that just some slokas are told, not like that.
They'll complete the Rigveda, they'll complete Yajurveda, they'll complete Paniniya Vyakarana. So this is a complete in-depth study of what they are learning, sir, with respect to Vedic studies.
Very good, excellent. Then the Veda and the current education. Third, what I asked, Sanskrit. Sanskrit. What is level of Sanskrit?
It is up to Mahabhashya they can learn, sir. Mahabhashya is a complete study of, actually understand Veda mantras. Up to that, he can study.
So Panini reads complete?
Yes. Panini is complete. Paniniya Vyakarana, he will completely study Paniniya Vyakarana.
Excellent, sir. It's a very great session for us.
Can I ask one question, please?
Yes.
Yeah, please. Go ahead.
Thank you. Please. Actually, thank you very much. It was very enlightening and knowledgeable.
Your name.
I'm sorry. I'm Naveen Kumar. I'm presently at Siliguri.
Okay.
Very good.
I'll say a basic doubt. Your education you're imparting is Vedic is from 4 to 10, that is 6 years.
Yes.
And thereafter, person can go on to his own stream. Now, after 6 years, those who don't want to go into the mainstream, that is Aparavidya, want to continue with this, what is there which you offer them? Because it's only 6 years. And if I am not wrong, the Adham Brahmacharya is up to 24 years.
Yes.
Is there something you are missing or trying to expand over in future?
Maybe, no, we don't see that kind of education to be given. We need to have scholars who need to be resided there in Gurukula, right, sir? We have only Rigveda scholars, Yajurveda scholar, and Paniniya Vyakarana scholar. So we should have a proper darshanics, like who has studied darshanas, yoga, mimamsa, nyaya, vaisheshika, and we should have Vedangas. We should have so one Vedanga we are teaching now. That is one Acharya Prabhakarji is actually teaching, and Somshekhar is one such Vedanga scholar. He has also studied darshanas, our own alumni.
So, you need more
scholars need to be present. Then we can, as long as he wants to complete whatever Vidya he can wants to study, he can study, sir.
The scholars are staying there only?
Yes, sir. Yes, it is a residence.
Even the teachers also will they be staying there only?
Yes.
So,
सर कैन आई शेयर वन
प्लीज
अभी एक प्रश्न पूछे थे कि जो व्यक्ति सारा पढ़ना चाहते हो उसके लिए कैसा है तो जैसे मैं अपना उदाहरण दूंगा क्योंकि मैं वहां का पढ़ा हूँ हमें शुरुआत में वहां पर जब हम रहते थे वहां पर शुरुआत में हमें एक दो साल तो ऋग्वेद यजुर्वेद का ऋग्वेद के मंत्रों का और भगवद्गीता पूरा 18 अध्याय और व्याकरण का सारी भूमिका बना दिए थे बेसिक्स बता दिए थे जिससे आगे जाकर हमें क्या पढ़ना है वो हम चुन लिया जैसे कि मैंने व्याकरण पढ़ने का चुना मैं वहां पर और 3-4 साल रहकर व्याकरण में थोड़ा और आगे तक बढ़ा अब मुझे और आगे के पढ़ने थे जैसे कि व्याकरण पूरा महाभाष्य तक पढ़ना था और दर्शन आदि शास्त्रों को अभी मुझे पूरा पढ़ना था वहां पर जहां तक वो पढ़ा वहां पर पढ़ना तो मैं पढ़ लिया उसके बाद आगे कहां पर किस गुरु के पास मैं क्या पढ़ सकता हूँ उसका पूरा पूरा मार्गदर्शन फिर मुझे शांतिधाम की ओर से मिलता रहा जो हमारा पाठ शुरू किए थे क्योंकि मेरा व्याकरण या वैदिक पाठ शुरू किए थे श्रद्धा भगिनी ने श्रद्धा जी थे वहां पर श्रद्धा भगिनी ने उन्होंने शुरू किए थे मेरा आगे व्याकरण समाप्ति में कहाँ करूँ फिर दर्शनों को मैं कहाँ पढ़ू श्रोत सूत्रों को कहाँ पढ़ू वो पूरा फिर मार्गदर्शन हमें मिलता रहा तो ये कभी संभव नहीं है कि एक जगह पर सभी चीजें मिले वहां पर अभी ऋग्वेद यजुर्वेद व्याकरण तो मिल रहा है बाकी का पढ़ना है तो वहां पर जो विद्वान है वो हमें मार्गदर्शन करते रहेंगे कहाँ जाकर हम और क्या पढ़ सकते हैं तो मार्गदर्शन तो मिलता रहेगा उसमें कोई समस्या नहीं रहेगी
धन्यवाद वेरी गुड एनीबडी एल्स वुड लाइक टू स्पीक ललिता जी प्लीज आस्क आई थिंक
रत्नम जी वांट्स Namaste, Mahodaya.
Yes, yes.
It was a very good thing that Somashekhar Shastri Sarmagaru has confirmed the education system in the Gurukula. And I think I have heard a number of Vedic schools around Hyderabad and Bodapalli and type of places, but they are not having this parallel type of education. And now that Somashekhar Sarma has also confirmed that he is very much he can choose whatever a student can choose whichever line he has to go. This is very, very good, sir. And congratulations to Om Shanti Dhamam and all you people who are doing such good work there. And looking forward for more such education institutions coming up in Hyderabad and also in Bharat. Thank you. Yeah.
Mahodaya, just now Prabhu sir has joined.
Prabhu sir, swagatam Prabhu sir.
I wanted to ask one question the speaker.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
May I know your academic affiliation? Is it Arya Samaj related or is it Chinmaya Mission related or what? What kind of Panini Vyakaranam are you teaching? Saralatam Vidhi and Ashtadhyayi Paddhati, are you teaching Kaumudi Paddhati or?
Ashtadhyayi, sir. Ashtadhyayi. We are mostly it is from Arya Samaj background only it has been started, but it is not stuck to Arya Samaj. We are open to all philosophies and all kinds of faiths, sir.
I'm focusing on the Paniniya grammar part.
Yeah, Paniniya grammar. Yes, Paniniya Vyakarana.
No. Which particular methodology you are following?
Ashtadhyayi.
Ashtadhyayi, fine. But I'm asking whether it is Brahmadatta Jijnyasu's methodology or Paushpya methodology or Yudhishthir Mimamsak that, you know, Ashtadhyayi Bhashya and how do you go up to Mahabhashya and what steps you are going?
This question can be answered by the concerned Upadhyaya, sir. I'm only organization level. I'm just sharing you what is going on with Om Shantidham. The final details, our concerned Upadhyayas and Acharyas will be able to guide you and tell you, sir. Right now, they are not here.
So you are, but basically, it started with Arya Samaj.
Yes. Faith.
Hello.
Mahodaya, can we conclude, Mahodaya? It is time for the meeting.
Yeah. Yes. Would you like to speak anything or shall we conclude?
Yeah, yes, we conclude, Mahoday. Everybody has spoken, Mahoday.
Yeah. Dr. Vishalakshmi.
It is 6:30, they wanted the time, it seems. So, that, yeah, we'll conclude, yeah. Mahoday.
Yeah, please, Vishalakshmi, please, would you like to conclude the session? Or Dr. Prabhu would like, Dr. Prabhu would like to speak or ask, shall I ask Vishalakshmi to speak?
No, I've not heard the whole lecture. I just came in, so I will not be able to do justice if I speak.
Okay, sir. So, Dr. Vishalakshmi, please speak. Please conclude the session. The later after that, Shanti Mantram and Jaragadamana.
Namaste, everybody. Today, really, it's a very good and very excellent lecture which we could listen due to our fortune as our honorable president of our Veda Sanskrit Samiti, Sri Akala Prabhakar Rao garu said, what we are thinking and what we wanted to implement is being really practically implemented by you, that is your organization, Om Shanti Dhamma Gurukula Pathasala. Gurukula Pathasalas are very much required for us, the Indians, and not only for Indians, in fact, for all human beings, at least for us, Indians and Hindus, which was, since lakhs of years, which was being in practice, but due to certain reasons, we could not, that is, we are just following, we have been overburdened by foreigners, in fact, by their way of education. So, your Shanti Dhamma Gurukula Pathasala is really maintained and run according to our Sanatana Dharma, according to our Sampradaya. For this, we are really very happy. And such Gurukula Pathasalas should exist all over India, certainly. And in fact, in other countries also, because our Hindus are there, all over the world. So we should try to start such Gurukula Pathasalas all over the world, because since the universe has become a family now, global, what we say that Udara Tirthanam to Vastaika Kutumbakam, and also this global feeling. You are doing a great service to our Sanatana Dharma by teaching our Vedic education in our traditional way. This is great job, which is very essential for us. And also, especially at this time of crisis, where there is a great threat to, and it is a great challenge to our Sanatana Dharma, which all of us are aware of, due to two main other religions which wanted to overpower us and which wanted to occupy and try to eliminate and demolish our Sanatana Dharma. So our Sanatana Dharma, which is since lakhs of years, has been struck several times by foreign invaders, Muslim invaders, and also by foreigners who ruled us forcibly. Forcibly made our minds get polluted and deviated from our Sanatana Dharma and the way of life which we have to lead since at least 300 years, since we can say. So this type of educational system should come, and they have, the foreigners, in fact, due to this Macaulay way of education, they introduce their culture, their civilization, their way of behavior in life, which is in fact foreign to us and which is not at all essential, even not at all to be cared by us. That has been imposed on us by force. So we should come out of that sort of power. And since a few hundreds of years, we are all following that education system, and yet because our great Maharshis made us to follow our way of life, our tradition, in our behavior, in our mindset, in our thinking, in our daily routine life, since the birth to the time of leaving the body. So we got accustomed to our Hindu customs, and even then, even Medhavi people are sometimes getting polluted by the wrong ideals, which because they could not got the chance of studying our history, our mythology, our Vedic knowledge, Vedas, since several years. So those who are maintaining our tradition and sacrificing their lives by studying Vedas and trying to preserve the sanctity of Vedas and preserve these Vedas, Vedic knowledge, and pass on to the coming generations, we are very much, we should show our gratitude to them. Due to them, this Sanatana Dharma is being maintained here, and also we Hindus, Hindus could live according to our Sanatana Dharma. So this sort of Gurukula Pathasalas, which is our Sahaja Tattva, it should come out, the way of life, which we have to live perfectly. We should, all Indians, we should try to, whoever start to want to start any type of school, now we should pray, we should advise them to start Gurukula Vidya Vidhanams, Gurukula Pathasalas. So these Gurukula Pathasalas, as many as possible, should be created here. And in fact, Dr. Sri Pramod Ji, you have given a very nice explanation and introduction of the education system which is being followed there in Shantidhama. And also in general, you spoke about Paravidya, Aparavidya. You have started with Vedic philosophy of education. And then you spoke about the importance of acharyas and also shishyas, the students, antevasis. And you say you said paravidya and aparavidya. And in fact, that is true. The paravidya should be the aim of our education and our life. Because so we are so fortunate, we could get the upadhi of human beings. So the to gain paravidya is the motive of our life, by which we can know ourselves and get moksha, which is final liberation. As we say, in fact, that is not liberation, that is moksha, that is the jnana, jnana devatu kaivalyam. We say that the real jnana can be gained only by paravidya. And in fact, Mundaka Upanishad also says, dve vidye veditavye paracha chaiva aparacha. Tatra apara rugvedo yajurveda samavedo atharvaveda shikshalpo vyakaranam niruktam chando jyotishamiti atha para yaya tadaksharam adhigamyate. So including all the Vedas, they have completely set aside all the Vedas and the branches of education. Thousands of branches of education are there, though we are saying for chaturdasha vidyas, 14 vidyas are there. All these come under aparavidya because they teach us how we have to lead the life here on the earth as perfect human beings, supporting nature and doing service to all human beings, and also leading very happy and healthy, happy life here on this earth. And also after iha para, we say, para, that is iha amutra. After leaving this body also, we have to, we can get the, that is, we can reach up to Hiranyagarbha's the loka, that is Devaloka, Indra, Swarga, as we say, and so many other lokas due to upasanas and all. But all these are temporary, and only paravidya, which we learn, that which takes us to the mukti patha, mukti moksha, and our self-realization, our jnana, which makes us know what we are. Aham brahmasmi jnana. So that is only tad aksharam adhigamyate, says the Upanishad. That is the knowledge of atma, self-knowledge, brahma jnana. So studying Vedas and knowing that all this ephemeral world and all these mundane happiness, they are all temporary. And then after getting educated, the knowledge of Upanishads and Upanishad Vijnana, we gain the Paravidya. So you are teaching first, formerly we have to, because we are born as human beings, we should do our duties. We should do our duties as student and as citizen, as any person. So we should fulfill all these, for which this Vedic education is very essential. And after that, the real essence of education also should be taught. And you said, you have shown us very wonderfully Shanti Dhamma, the activities being conducted in your own Shanti Dhamma Gurukula Pathashala. The children, the students are really so disciplined. They did their prayers, Vedic chantings, Vedic hymns, which is very melodious to our ears. And also they have prayed at the time of taking their Alpahara, and also at the time of taking Bhojana. The prayers are very nice, which is the correct habit of us, the Hindus, according to our ancient tradition. And also the teachers, we could see the very good acharyas teaching Vedic mantras and Vyakarana, Jivhamulya, and all they have explained. It's very nice. And also we could get the fortune of seeing Goshala. You are maintaining this Goshala, and the milk of the cows are being utilized for the children, for the students. It's really very all the gods and deities stay in Gomata, and those who stay at Goshala or near the cows, they will be physically, mentally, spiritually very healthy, and they get such divine power also. So it's very good education, Gurukula Pathashala, I think. And also you said you are getting admitted to all those children who are coming to you, approaching you, that is your Pathashala, with interest of joining and getting education of Vedas, Vedic mantras, Samhitas and all. And also you said Rigveda, Yajurveda, and then Paniniya, Vyakarana, which are very essential for us Hindus, are being taught there, that too from 4th class to 10th class. That is the excellent age of the children. Actually, when they are very small children, they cannot understand. Normally, they should be under the care of mother and father. That is correct. And when their mind gets a little matured and they get the knowledge to grasp and to stay a little away from parents and under the parental care of good teachers like you, Acharyas and all, Gurukula Pathashalas, you are getting admitted them. And then up to 10th, their mind get matured by that time. Till that time, you are molding all our Hindu children, Vidyarthis, in such beautiful way, which makes them certainly become great, useful Hindu, that is personification. And also you are teaching modern education and also Vedic education, by which either the parents or anybody of the society need not have to worry about the future of the children, because they will be able to join in any course of education after they complete 10th at your care. And also we are very happy that they are able to learn Vedas, which is the real essential education of us, the Hindus. So really it's very ideal. And in fact, you have spoken on so many other members, honorable members of our group also. They have spoken about so many other Gurukula Pathashalas, but your Gurukula Pathashala is really excellent, I think. And also I know about a person, Bharati Swamiji. He is also, irrespective of creed or anything, whoever approached them with interest, for them, he is teaching. Formally, what he is doing is he will instruct their parents, that the mother and father, the family members of the children, the boys whom they want to get to send to them for education, they should take a oath that all of them will get, especially the students, children, they should get up before sunrise and complete their Kalakrityas, start getting educated, steady under the teaching of the masters there. And second condition is, even the mother and father of the children who are getting not admitted who are coming to this Vardhi Swamiji's ashrama, the mother and father also, they should not touch this madhya or mamsa, because when till that time they might have eaten in their life, but from that moment they should stop in their life throughout. They should take a vote, then only he will take these boys, and they should promise that they will not take madhya or mamsa, anything, because the children after studying here or even in between taking leave, they may go to the home naturally. Then at that time, if suppose they eat this and drink or anything, then the sanctity and the purity which they are getting and gaining here in this ashrama under the guidance of this Swamiji and his main disciples, that will be lost. So they will not be able to get the ability to learn Vedas, and also not only ability, arhata also should be there to learn any sort of education. There is a, just as for joining in degree, inter should child should get past the inter. So thus 10th when they complete, then only they'll be able to join inter. So thus arhata is there to study Vedas, which are very having swara. So for that he has kept this condition, and for that we are happy. And then irrespective of caste, all types of students, boys, either Brahmins or Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Sudras, ST, ST, BC, anybody, if they are Hindus, he is allowing them and giving them, first they are teaching Purusha Sukta, Narayana Sukta, Sri Sukta, Vishnu Sukta, Vishnu Sahasranama, Bhu Sukta, Medha Sukta, Anna Sukta, such suktas they are teaching them first. Then afterwards, they are teaching the boys how to worship the idol. That is idol worship. How to do worship puja, small temples, not big temples, only Grahamadevi temples, which are temples of any village, any city. Teaching the way of learning this. And also,
madam, your voice is breaking, madam. Mahode, bhavata swaram sabhyak na
agachati. Inter conclude, mahodaya. It is getting late for
them. Yeah.
It is getting late.
Sambhik nasti, swaram sambhik nasti.
Could you vinipista?
Amma, idi vallaku late avutam antamma, vallaku late avutam antanta.
గురించి చెప్పదామని వెళ్ళేదామంటే పరిధి స్వామి కూడా గుళ్ళల్లో మన సనాతన
ఇంకొక సెషన్ పెట్టుకుందామమ్మా. ఇప్పుడు వీళ్ళు చెప్పిన దాని గురించి ఇచ్చేద్దాం ఈ రోజు.
ఆపేస్తున్నా, ఉండి ఒక్క నిమిషం. అలా ఆయన కూడా అంటే మన సనాతన ధర్మం రక్షించబడాలి అని అంటే అందరికీ కూడా మనం అవకాశం ఇవ్వాలి అనే భావనతో ఆయన గుళ్ళల్లో ఆచార్యులుగా వీళ్ళని తయారు చేసి పంపిస్తున్నారన్నమాట. సో ఇప్పుడు మన శాంతిధామం దాంట్లో వేదాలు నేర్పిస్తున్నారు అని అంటే అది చాలా గొప్ప విషయం. సో ఇలాంటి గారు వీళ్ళందరూ కూడా నిర్వహిస్తున్న ఈ ఓం శాంతిధామ గురుకుల పాఠ చక్కగా వర్తిల్లాలని, అలాంటి పాఠశాలలు మనం కూడా ఇంకా చాలా అందరూ నిర్వహించాలని కోరుకుంటూ స్వస్తి.
ధన్యవాదాలు. I just wanted to remind you that national education policy, is it congenial to you, or any problems are there? That just one question I have got.
Well, most of them are quite congenial, sir. It is I was also one of the members who actually advised to the NEP committee.
Okay.
I was there. We were as Om Shanti Dhamma group members, we went there. And we advise some of our suggestions. And in fact, one of our scholars who is from Shantidham is also now currently member of National Education Policy there. So that's there. So I'll share in detail with about that later, sir.
Nice of you. Let us close with Chant Mantram.
Yeah.
Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pasyantu, Makachit-dukkha-bhag-bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahana Bhunaktu Sahaviryankara Vavahai. Tejasvina Vadhi Tamastuma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Satcham Vada Dharman Chara Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Guru Brahma Guru Vishnu Guru Devo Maheshwaraha. Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sarvasri Krishna Arpanamastu Idam Namo Hari Om Janaganamana
Janaganamana Dhinayaka Jayahe Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindhu Gujarata Maraka Dravidam Kalalanga Vindhya Himachalaya Ganga Ujjwala Jalita Ranga Tava Subhaname Jage Tava Subhashishamahe Gahe Tava Jayagata Janagana Mangala Daya Gajaya Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Jayahe 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 Jayahe
Jayahe
Jayahe Jayahe
Jayahe Jayahe
Jayahe Jayahe